Jason here at Fraser Valley Rose Farm. I wanted to take a quick video today on fertilizer, and most specifically I'm going to be looking at how not to over-fertilize your plants. The way I'm going to show you how to do that is with a gadget I use called the Direct Stick EC Tester, and that's going to be able to show me when I've got too much fertilizer going into the soil. So stand by and I'll get set up here. This is the gear I'm going to use to try to show you what I do for testing fertility in soil. The tester itself is this guy here. It's a Soil Direct EC probe. You see it's built a little differently than some of the other ones on the market. The other ones usually have kind of a detachable probe or one on a wire that goes right down into a water solution to test EC. I find it very convenient, but not as accurate, to test directly in the soil. And I'll explain why in just a minute here. I guess going to back to the basics, when you look at a plant that you're testing the fertility in the soil, what you're not testing is the soil itself. You're testing the water that's in the soil, because the water is what carries the fertilizer. So to get a good reading of what the fertility is in the soil, what a lot of people use is what's called a pore-through EC test. And a pore-through EC test, sorry, just getting open my bottle of water here. And ideally, you should use distilled water for something like this. What you would do is pour a known amount of water in through the top of the pot to force the water out from the bottom or the inside of the pot, so then it dribbles through to the base. And I wanted to take a second to talk about the impracticality of this kind of test as you're working in a nursery or greenhouse. So let's say I'm walking around and I'm trying to test many crops, and I don't know whether any of them are in trouble over fertility issues. Going and walking around with a bunch of bowls like these, or a bunch of pie plates or trays of some sort, a whole bunch of distilled water, taking the time to make sure they have the right moisture level before I do it, then pouring through, and then waiting the allotted amount of time and then coming back can be a fair amount of time and follow-up and everything else, especially if what I really need to know is just if they're in trouble. Now, going back to how to test with this thing, this can test directly in water as well. And I've just stuck it in some water there, and you're going to see that even water, this water's directly from a water bottle. So even coming directly out, it has some conductivity. So that's what it's measuring, is how electricity moves through water. And if you remember your high school science classes, if that had been distilled water in there, it would probably be a much, much lower rating. It would just be conducting just based on impurities that are in the water. So salts are what helps the water to conduct electricity. And I would show you here that this here, I'm just adding in some calcium nitrate to show you what happens to the reading there, because it definitely will go up. The other thing I wanted to show you is that these are what I use a fair amount for fertilizing, and these are controlled release fertilizer. So when I incorporate that into the soil, usually at a known rate, as I bag the soil or mix the soil. And what will happen is, over time, it releases depending on moisture and temperature. So if the temperature went way higher than I was expecting, or the roots aren't well enough established yet, and it's not taking up the fertilizer, what can happen is the controlled release fertilizer can begin releasing faster than the plant can take it up. And so, whereas you might expect to see a fertility rate in your soil through the pore-through test, that when if you had done the pore-through test here, and you found that the fertility were somewhere around 1 or below 1, that would be appropriate for seedlings and cuttings and plants that don't need high fertility levels. As you push up towards 1.5 and 2 and 2.5, you're moving into plants that require, or that would be an appropriate level for plants that require a lot more fertilizer. So if you had a reading of 2 on a tomato, that'd be okay. But if you had a reading of 2 on a brand new stuck seedling, it would not be okay. That would probably not allow it to develop its roots properly. So that's what I'm looking for, is if I'm trying to establish new plants and I find that number through the pore through test to be very, very high, like in that 2 or 3 or 4 range, then I'm concerned that the plant isn't going to make it. So here I've taken and added, and holy, 5.5 or 5.4. So just by adding a teaspoon of, that was calcium nitrate, the water solution has become toxic to plants. If you put that into a plant and tried it to grow it with it, that would burn the roots, and you've over-fertilized your plant. So I'll return to this guy here in a minute, because it hasn't really dribbled out enough yet to give me a proper reading. So I want to show you how the meter works as direct stick. And soil, if I'm testing it directly in the soil, you're going to see a very, very low reading. In fact, you're going to see a lower reading trying to test in dry soil than you would see as water that comes directly out of the tap. If you think about it, that makes sense. The probe is going to have a much harder time pushing electricity through soil that has all its air pockets and solids in it than it would pushing it through the liquid. What I've found in the past is that if you use a multiple of around 4, you're going to get the proper level. Now, it's not accurate to the degree that pore through would be, but for my purposes, I don't actually need it to be accurate. I just need it to tell me when my plants are in danger. Sticking this one through. 0.3. What does that mean? So times it by 4, and I get a 1.2. 1.2, as I mentioned, is an appropriate level for a plant that isn't requiring a whole lot of nutrients. So that's good. I'm happy with where that is. You can see, even with small movements in the soil, that this fluctuates a little bit. That's okay. If I'm doing that, I can just stab it a few times and sort of average it. And as long as it doesn't make the results change too much, I'm happy to go with it. Now, I'm in winter now, and I wouldn't expect that a whole lot of anything I have here, because I haven't been fertilizing it recently, is going to have much more than if the equivalent of a 0.8 to a 1.2. So I'm not going to be able to show you anything that actually is in danger unless I spiked it purposely. So I'm going to return back here and show you from the pore through test. And that's the leachate there. And see if I can get a number off of that one. Within the safe range, which is really all I needed to verify. So I'm going to return this one back to its tray. And that is my quick and easy, or fast and dirty way, to check whether I've over-fertilized the plants in my greenhouse. I hope this was helpful to you. I understand that it can get a bit messy when you start talking those numbers and conversions, but if you do have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Thank you.